Welcome to episode 40 of the Alex Steele Show. It's fantastic to have you here. Thank you for joining us on this fantastic end of April day. What is the date today, Sam? 29th of April. Why might Sam know that? Well, everybody, if we could all wish Sam a happy birthday. It was his birthday yesterday. Sam is now 13 years old. Congratulations, Sam. He's not. Just turned 30. So on today's episode, I've got a piece of inch round steel in the fire. Big old piece of steel. We're gonna make a spear. It's gonna be a lot of fun. I've never made a spear. I've never made a socket this large. So I'm very excited to work my way through this process. And hopefully at the end of the stream, we'll have ourselves a spearhead that we can show you all. Very excited to do this. It's gonna be a lot of material move, a lot of material to isolate, mess around with. And it's just fantastic to have you all here. All good with YouTube, Sam?
Yeah.
All good, everybody's coming on in. Fantastic. Twitch, everybody on Twitch having fun and happy. Brilliant. Fix the exposure a little bit. Golly. Make sure we're all good. We're good. Should we do some forging? I think we will. I think we'll do some forging. It's hot. Right. Let's do it. I'll take a little bit of material here. I'll probably take about an inch of this material. Oh, shouldn't have put a glove on. I've lost all my dexterity here. Inch of material or so. How's the exposure on the close shot? It is still a little light though. I'm gonna adjust that. Well, actually, I'll keep that out. It's not changing anything. Third time it's on auto. Oh. There we go. That's a little better. Should be good. Now, sorry, I'll switch that back around so you can see it. Lovely. Jolly good. Lovely to have you all here. So, straight razor went great. Really excited with how that turned out. Lots of you guys weren't. Comments were riddled with so much, so much distress over my handle choice. As if it really affected your, you know, a lot of the viewers seem to be very affected by my handle choice. I actually thought the G10 was a pretty cool handle choice. I think it looked nice. So, you know, whatever. Not everybody is always gonna be happy, but that's okay. I was overall very pleased. I'm gonna need to get either a higher grit stone. Lots of people suggested I just get a dedicated leather strop, saying that that would work better than compound on a buffing wheel. So I'll give that a try, see if that'll get it a little sharper. You know, obviously it took the hairs off my arms effortlessly and didn't have any problems about that. I might just not know how sharp a straight razor needs to be. I might be overestimating it. Who knows? I'm gonna get myself a leather strop and I see if I can sharpen it up properly. And then I guess we'll get Sam to grow out his beard, big beard, and maybe then we'll be able to try it, do a video. Or maybe just wait, you know, 15 years until I can grow a beard. That would equally work. Couple blows to polish it. I'm not sure. Oh, you know what? No, there's no need for that. I can go straight to isolating it. That'll be perfectly fine. So what I'm gonna do next heat is I'm going to isolate it over that far edge of the anvil. Maybe I should have done that the other way around. I should have probably forged the socket first. That would have been a lot easier. But my anvil is being very loud today because it's not properly mounted. So I'm gonna tighten up these bolts. I'm gonna run and get a wrench or some sort of tightening device real fast. See what I have here in the toolbox. Perfect. Boom, get a 17 millimeter socket and give the anvil a little bit of a tighten. What's going on, guys? All good?
Only a knife, just say buy a leather belt.
Buy a leather belt, I have one on.
They said you can get one for your belt grinder for sharpening.
Oh, a leather belt on it. That's a cool idea. That's a very cool idea. Leather grinding belt. Well, leather stropping belt for the grinder. Very cool idea. Ah, oh, much better. No point having that ringing around. Obnoxious noise. Load up some comments here. How are we all doing? Samurai made me a box, and it's unbelievable. It's absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful box he made me. I'm thrilled about it. That video is going to get released tomorrow.
Steve C. just made a donation. Says thanks for being an inspiration.
Thank you very much, Steve.
Steve,
thank you very much. Very kind of you. So one of my worries here, as often happens on the live show when I'm trying something new, is, you know, I don't know exactly the steps I'm going to take, so I'll do a little bit, then I'll do a little bit somewhere else. But what happens is it takes such a long time, they end up over-oxidizing the piece. A way that one can avoid this is by not quite finishing everything until the very end. That's going to be a little bit of the way that I'm going to go with this. I'm going to try and keep everything pretty proud and just take the different parts of it down as I go. So that at the end, you know, the finished forging hopefully won't get too oxidized and I can maintain a little bit of a crisper aesthetic to the piece. I'm gonna give that a go. You know, again, it's very much, you know, trying to constantly make decisions as to where the next hammer blow is gonna be placed to achieve what. And it's just a part of the fun and part of the difficulty, trying to work out where to go next and doing a little bit at a time here, a little bit at a time there. Hopefully it's gonna help me out. Hopefully. Make this isolation a little bit narrower. Extend it up here a little bit more. Now, when I go on to forging the socket, I'm gonna want another type of out. Rough octagon like the rest of it there. Oh, rough octagon-like thing there. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So, one of the things that I've had struggles with, I've forged very few sockets in my time. If you go back to that one there, very few sockets in my time. One of the things I've had struggled with is getting a wide enough socket at the base of it so it still wraps around. So I'm gonna leave it very much thicker. I'm not gonna attack the base of my socket anymore. That's the idea, at least. We're gonna see how this goes. Sorry? By looking at the
place to forge, i.e. paying for a space to work.
How do I recommend somebody find a place to forge paying for a space? That's a tough one, really. It depends so much on where you are. Industrial units can be very expensive, you know, when you get over a certain size. This is like a little bit of a rinky-dink industrial unit in a city. They exist, you know, otherwise, you know, hey, maybe you know somebody that has a garage that's willing to let you put a forge in there and drag it out and forge outside, something like that. You know, in terms of the setup that's required to do it, it's not all that involved. You can have, you know, a little hand truck and pick up your anvil and drag it outside and drag out your forge. And with an anvil and a forge, you can do a lot. You know, you can mount a vice on an anvil. It's those two pieces of equipment that are the only thing. And you can forge with them outside, kind of anywhere that somebody will let you. So it's, I guess it'd be the case of just asking anybody that has a little space whether they can let you practice their hobby out on their drive, out on their farm, wherever it is. You don't need to take up masses of space with equipment to get into it and have some fun. You know, get an anvil, get a forge. Total stored space, 2 square feet. Sorry?
Everything just dropped out temporarily. It's not back on again.
Ouch. I think they've downgraded my Wi-Fi service, because uploading my videos has taken a lot longer here too. That's going to be where it transitions into the spear itself. Hopefully that goes well. And then that's where the socket begins. It's going to be where the socket... Hello everybody, we're back. Sorry that we're having these issues. I might have overestimated my bandwidth. We can always drop down, if we drop out completely again, Sam, let me know. Change the settings. We'll drop down the quality of one of the streams. At least keep one high one up. I've tried making my own steel from scratch. No, I haven't. I've never tried making my own steel from scratch. What else? What else? Any interesting comments coming through on YouTube? Next hammer order. I don't know when I'm going to do the next hammer order. No idea on the date on that. Probably not going to be another big pre-order for a long time, like the last ones. Just too busy making the videos. I still have a large batch to make before the end of May. Got to make 70, which is going to be a lot of tiring work. A lot of fun though. Once they're out, I might decide. Who knows? Okay. Ah, there we go. That's still nice and thick there. I was tilting my round die over a little bit as I did it. I'm now going to start working on the head of the spear a little more. Keep the rest out of the fire. So again, I have no clue what I'm doing with this. Having not made a square, I made a spear. I'm just trying to imagine my way through this. I think it'll be all right. Again, my worries are excessive oxidation from having to do too much work. My worries are also getting a wide enough socket. That's why I made sure to go with some big material. This is inch round material. So I think I got plenty of material there to make a wide socket when I draw it out. The only risk, however, is if I do too much heating, I might not have I might oxidize the socket so much that it doesn't want to work. So these are the issues that I have to deal with as I'm thinking about how I maneuver around this forged piece. Aside from that, just moving some metal around, really, you know? Nothing too different from anything else.
I haven't lost them, but it sounds like
he
gold.
Didn't hear what he said earlier. You've got to repeat what he said, because they can't hear that. Otherwise, it just is you coming out of the blue going, I still have the voice, which is still probably equally funny. Who noticed? Did somebody notice? Woo! Outstanding. Congratulations on noticing the fixed shelf. Lock that in the box. And back in the fire we go. So here we are. Started to flatten out the spear itself. There's that transition into the socket material. It's going well. It's going well. I'm excited. Oh. Xander the Gamer, I did get your email. Drew Smith.
Says they have a challenge for you. They say the Spiderweb Damascus pattern for your 250,000 sub video.
Spiderweb Damascus pattern. Now, I've seen a guy make some cool spiderweb looking stuff. So it's possible. I might have to ask him how he does it. 250,000 is coming up. That's unbelievable. I can't believe it. I cannot believe it. Definitely got to make a 250,000 subscriber celebration of some sort. Be it a spiderweb, be it something else, open to suggestions. God, wow. It's a big number when you think about it. Little old me in my little rinky-dink workshop. Oakley pokey. What's the issue that we're having there?
Fixed it.
It's just that one auto wheel up top.
How's the forge, right?
This forge right here, ladies and gentlemen, is a prototype forge. The Fowler Steel prototype forge right there. It's working great. Little one burner forge, it'll probably just sip at the propane. I'm excited with it. It's working great. No issues with it. Because it is a small orifice, you know, you're moving it at a higher velocity. It's a little louder than running a larger orifice. That means for a smaller forge, you get less propane usage. Do I have tips when preventing warping during the quench with Damascus knives? I absolutely do not, sadly. That's something I'm still trying to learn. Now, okay, few tidbits of information that I've picked up. You know, make sure you do some normalizing cycles. Apart from that, what I've also been doing with some pretty good results is doing what I believe is referred to as you can still see me kind of like a little bit of a bend. Very effective to the craft. A little bit of cross section. We'll strike up. Remember, guys, if you have any questions that you want asked, answered, use the super chat feature in the YouTube comments. That'd be great. Appreciate that big time. And that way we can sift through it all. How many viewers are watching right now, Sam?
It's about 1,300 last time I looked.
Oh.
My eggs just broke down.
Really? Okay.
650, right?
That's no good. How often has it been dropping out now, Sam?
Third time it's done.
That's really not good. Should we just quickly, let me see what I can do. I switched that to 540, 480. See if this will switch. So if I want to change the output, I have to stop the stream and then start it again. That might make a second YouTube video, though. Okay.
Just leave it. This was actually on Wi-Fi.
Oh, well, we'll give it a go. You ready?
Yep.
So, not necessarily too hard at first. I just want to get my lines set up. Yep. Very nice. Very nice. Beautiful. Perfect. A little harder. So I'm going to try and run three grooves down here. And this way, keep it all in control of as to where my blows are and where they're going. I think this will work quite nicely. Sorry about that. That was fast. Great. Okay. We'll do a little bit of that on the blade. Yes, please. Let me just clean out the dirt from it. Appreciate it. Yeah, that's classed as a drink in the Alex Steel drinking game. When a fuller flies across the room. I've lost it too. I don't know where it went. Oh, here it is. Thank you very much. Ugh. No fullers were harmed. We're good. So we'll do the same in here. Me actually. What just happened is I touched my hand on that as I was holding the tool, and I winced and I shuffled it, and so that was all my fault. The tongs are hot. For you guys that didn't understand what happened, as I was positioning the tool down, I burnt my little pinky on the tongs, which meant that I jumped. Damn it, it's twisted now. So I lost the positioning, lost the hold. That's not good. Okay, we'll take another hit. So that's much to make a tool go, make a tool go flying.
Someone said,
God is here.
Is that you?
Fan meet up for 25k and over.
Fan meet up for 250k and over.
Where?
Exactly.
Where would we do a fan meet up? There's not much space here at the workshop. And I don't know how many people there are locally. Sorry? 1250 again, that's good. Okay. I'll try and not send this across the room this time. How about that? For the blade of the spear, however, and we're going to work slowly, making roughly the shape that I want. It's slowly getting there.
Let's
go to a pub. Have an orange juice. Then maybe we'll do a little meetup.
When will there be another hand-forged Damascus project?
When is there going to be another hand-forged Damascus project? Like the whole thing hand-forged? Like rarely, not very often? I prefer using the power hammer. Easier. Take a heat on the blade now. A little heat on the blade. Plenty of material to move around.
Would you consider making a video creating a horned anvil with a hardy hole from a railroad track?
Creating a whole anvil with a hardy hole from a railroad track. Yeah, that'd be all right. Wouldn't see any problem with that. Probably like flame cut out the waist and then draw out a horn and draw out the heel, hammer on the face a little bit. It'd be possible to forge it. I'd probably rather just forge one out of a big block of steel, you know? Like out of this, like forge a 10-pound anvil out of that. Probably be better. Squish it under the press, make some tooling up, and make a fun video. Be able to make a video of making the tooling, and then make a video making the actual thing. take another heat here with a hand hammer. Not a piece of Damascus. Because otherwise, if I do it all the time, it's just going to get boring to make Damascus. And it shouldn't be, because Damascus is fun as hell. But it's a reality. I need time to do other stuff. Plenty of other ideas I have, of things I want to make, projects I want to build. But we're going to keep pushing this whole Damascus wave forwards. And then we'll have a month without it, and then we can continue on. Are you heading off?
No. Are you still on this one?
Yes, on this one. Thank you. Sorry about that, bad timing. Great, take another little pass in here. I'll run through it one more time. Lovely. Thank you very much. I then flatten out that socket. When I do that, however, I think a couple more heats on the blade. Make sure that's all a little closer to where it needs to be. Then I'll go to the socket. Pick up a normal size hand hammer now. I have. Just never got around to it. I never find like a reputable dealer. Reputable. And I never ended up buying one. I'd love to have an induction forge. It'd be really great, especially for these live shows.
I have something baby to stick in this vice.
Should I? You know what he says at the end of his videos? I don't know why I only just thought of that. That would be pretty funny. But like, I have a PG audience. You know, like there is a certain. Sorry?
A hot dog, just like that t-shirt has.
I don't know, like you could say it was a hot dog, but it wouldn't look like a. Plus, oh God. I'd get all sorts of weird requests from all sorts of weird people after that. I don't think I can make anything for him to stick in his vice. That would probably be pushing it too far for the young contingency of the viewership. And when I mean young, I mean the very young contingency. One of the great things about this, I'm always really thrilled when parents say that they've found that they and their young children watch the videos and enjoy them. That's always really cool, and I'd hate to mess that up. by making AVE that type of present. Whoa, I missed again.
Are there any metals or alloys that you're wanting to use that are cost prohibitive?
Are there any metals or alloys that you've wanted to use but are cost prohibitive for you to use them? Absolutely. I want to work some gold. I want to forge some gold. Hot forging gold. I want to do it when we reach a million subscribers. But a kilogram of gold is not like the cheapest thing in the world. So, you know, but 1 million subscribers, I'd like to do that. Work some gold. Aside from that, I met him once at a blacksmithing conference. Not heard anything from him. I'll have to look into that. A couple of people have actually asked me about that. So, still the actual. Sorry? Damn it. Maybe. I'm gonna have it here handy. My first thought is to just hammer it out with a hand hammer. It's going to be cooling so fast that I want, like, fast pace of blows. I've never forged CK45 on Twitch. Will I go to VidCon? I've never thought about going to VidCon. Maybe at some point. I guess, you become... Makes starts to be sensible to go to some sort of conferences when you build followings, and I guess we're starting to build a YouTube following, which is pretty cool. That's one for the Alex Steele Live Show. Drinking game. Okay. So I'm basically just using the round side of my hammer here and flattening the daylights out of it. Yeah. And I think I'll use that large fuller and you can strike. I'm probably just gonna try and work my way up, maybe like this, nah, maybe like that. Oh sure, a little bit of both. But I think I'll use you striking. And then I'll go back to the blade, do a little more of the blade. What's going on Twitch? If you're not following me on Twitch, go do that for some weekly live streams throughout the week. Live streams here as I'm working in the workshop. It's always fun. I can set up a couple of cameras and just work and then come chat with you guys and read the comments. So if you go to Twitch, follow me there, Alex Steele, it'll all come up. I'm streaming to the Twitch at the same time today, which is fun. Sadly, though, it's what's experiencing these bandwidth issues, having the dual stream.
And the microphone issues.
And microphone.
I sound like God.
Oh.
The sound of the Mysterons, but that's probably a bit preview. Do you know who the Mysterons are?
No.
Do you know who the Mysterons are?
Ah. Alex, do a drinking game. You ready? Not too hard at all.
No,
can't run in there with a hand hammer, I think. Nice. Getting that to flare out around it nicely. Brilliant. Happy about that. Blade's nice and thick. I think I'm going to do a little more work on the socket before I go back to the blade, though. Thin down some more of the material. Take another good hot hammering heat. Wonderful. Is still shuffling across the stage. There we go, that's a little better, it's a little more central. I like that. Brilliant. Somebody from Sweden's gonna be going to school as a blacksmith in about 3 months. Fantastic. So yeah, next heat I'm gonna come back in with the round side of my hammer, I guess, and just start hammering away on that flat, bringing it down, moving it all around, thinning it down, getting a nice wide socket. I'm slipping down the handle. Somebody might screenshot that. That's a reference to all the comments that that people leave about me holding the hammer too high up the handle. Har 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 har. Exposed. Revealed. Alex Steele occasionally slips down the hammer handle. Ugly bogly. Take one more heat there, then I'll go back to the blade. Starting to get that nice width that I wanted. Apparently they want more volume on my mic. Just a smidge. Maybe, has he tried turning up the volume on his computer though? Come on, little forge, here we go. Still got some left, I'm all good. Just loads of dirt all around it. It's good, it's all nutrients. Right, let's take another heat. Okie dokie. Well, I'm quite happy with how that turning out. Still want a little more width in it. I'm going to go back to the blade though, take another heat there. Hopefully that doesn't fall out of the forge. dropped my tongue clip there, so you might not have noticed it, but that was one for the Alex Steel drinking game, after dropping the tongue clip. This is water. This is water I'm drinking. What's going on YouTube, Sam? We're not going on Forge and Fire. Good lordy. So many questions about it. It's going to deserve a dedicated video here in a second, isn't it? I'm going to have to make a dedicated video that why I'm not going to go on Forge and Fire. I answer it every single stream. And it's starting to get to be like a memorized little spiel. Basically, I'd rather make YouTube videos. I'd rather hang out with you guys here. Rather hang out with you guys here on YouTube, here on Twitch, here on Instagram, here on Facebook, than take 2 to 3 weeks of time to go out and do a TV show. That wasted all my heat getting the tongue clip on. And then brushing. Look at all that wasted heat. Okie dokie. I don't like that little kink that's occurring in there, so I need to be cautious of that. I need to make sure I fix that. I'm gonna straighten that out, and then I'm gonna take a heat on the socket. I wanna straighten it out now, because I don't want it flopping around. The more it's out there, the more likely it's gonna wanna bend back and forth and such. Let's see if I can attack that now. So as soon as it's hot there, right at that transition, vice, straighten it. Back in the forge, continue working on the socket. I'm gonna get some more width in there, and I think I'm gonna start doing that by attacking the edges a little more. Stay off them previously, you know, from what I remember from forging leaves. You know, I'm gonna start in the middle, work my way out while the edges still have heat. As soon as you work down the edges, then you go back to the middle and you work it, the edges cool down, the edges crack. Just like when you're working on a big leaf and you have cracks on the edges. It's from usually, and my little bit of experience there from what I learned from Brian Brazil, that tends to be from where one has forged the edges too soon, while there's still material to forge in the center. Okay. In I go to the Weiss. A little twist in there too. There we go. Sorry, a little too late. Actually, no, I'm gonna just work it this way, a little bit at a time. All the way across from side to side. Start curving the socket, I guess. Yeah, start curving around the socket. Should be fine, good time to do so. then flip it around, finish off the blade of the spear. What fun. Got one that's out of battery. No idea how long of a spearhead I was shooting for. I just started hammering. Doesn't look like it's going to be a very big spearhead. It'll get a little longer with some more work, but not much. This is about where it's going to be at. It's a little small spear. Oakley doakley. Wonderful, back in the fire I go, keep working it back, almost done there with the socket. Soon ready to cut it off. Golly, it's warm in the workshop tonight. Ooh, a little rocket. That's great. There's no real difference in this forge, you know, between the last one. It's just like in terms of how fast it heats up, it's just heat. So there's no difference. It's just working fine. Little small burner. It's a little louder. But this is gonna be a great little once Sam has this prototype all worked out. This is gonna be a great little budget. Great little budget forge, great way to get into the craft. Turned the forge off. I think I'm gonna get a chisel real fast, and this will allow me to cut her off. Make sure I got some glyphs, good glove for my hand. Big old piece like this, gonna be lots of radiant heat. Square and mark from here all the way across. Thinking about it, how thin that is, I probably just destroyed my chisel cutting all the way through the material into the anvil. We'll see. Okie dokie. Great. Nice and thin, just in case it might just want to break off. It might just break off on me. In which case that's good, because all that scoring was all I needed to do. Oh, it might do. Great, let's go to the vise. A little bit more secure breaking off. Give her the old Scottish yank back and forth. And howdy hoody, here we go. It's broken off. I can set my steel somewhere safe. How am I going to hold on to that? I know how I'm going to hold on to it. We'll give her a go with these. This should work all right. You know, I've still actually got a much thicker right in there than I thought I was. So I'll do some more forging out there. Get a little more width into it. This is an exciting little project. I'm enjoying myself. Now I'll turn the forge back up a touch. Mega Damascus cable internet modem, that's how you get the fastest. That's how you get the fastest internet, let me tell you that. Ah. No longer need the chisel, I'm gonna put this back. Otherwise I'll be tripping over it for weeks until I finally get around to putting it back. I don't need this glove.
Steve Squint says, I'll give you an account to Simulcast server. Push your stream to Twitch, Facebook, and YouTube. You only need to upload one stream.
That's a very good idea. So we can only upload, we can upload to one place and it'll go everywhere. What's the name of it?
It's a Simulcast.
Simulcast. Great. Love to look into that. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Take another hit. I believe Drew Smith suggested that a little earlier. KX the Wolf on Twitch asks, Alec, how would I contact you if I want a commission done? I don't take commissions. Very sorry to have to say that. Okie dokie. Here, mandrel to form the socket. I might also get lucky, and it might just kind of come together pretty nicely as I hammer it. We'll see. I'm going to probably also need a bottom swage and a cross pin, so I'm going to sort all that out.
Hi.
Yep.
There's a lot of viewers on YouTube.
Why?
It's not watching.
They can't. Ugh, hum. Is it completely off? Like nobody's watching? Is it really bad? What are they saying?
It's all buffering.
Okay, great. What I'm gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna stop the stream and I'm gonna come back real fast with new settings. We're back. Sorry, guys, we've had some serious issues with the bandwidth, with the Wi-Fi for the streaming. Big apologies, tried streaming to two platforms at once. Didn't necessarily go to plan. We went to YouTube and Twitch, 720 and 720. Seems like it's not holding up to it, which is weird, because I'm pretty sure we've done streams like this before without an issue going to Facebook. It's not working. Oh well, we're back for round two. We're forging a spear. I'm working on the socket right now, and hopefully this is going to be going a little bit better. I'm just about getting set to do a little more work to it, and then I'm going to start curling up the socket. Here we go. So, clamish it all out. I want to bring out some more material from this side here. Okay, there we go. And now I'm going to get ready next heat to start curving it. Bro. Now for this, I'm going to need a bottom swage to forge it in. Is it all working, Sam? Is it on the same YouTube stream?
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Sorry, guys. We're back. Hopefully for good. That is a shame. That means the whole video is messed up on the YouTube thing too. Or is that a swage? It was a swage. I'm gonna nab myself a crossbeam too. So there's a little bottom swage right there we're gonna be using. Help curl it all up. Put this back in the fire, grab a little crossbeam. What time is it, Sam?
Time now is 20 past 9.
Great. It's all good. Twitch people are saying it's good. So that's all good. How are YouTube people saying the quality is good?
Yeah, I mean there's still a few people a bit behind on it, so they're not having problems now as opposed to.
Take another heat. That crossbeam's a little narrow for it. And you notice I'm not coming out at very hot heats because I don't want to be oxidizing this too much. Now I have another crossbeam somewhere. It's got a little bit of a thicker peen. Have I found it? Not really. It's a little better. This will have to do for now. It's amazing how many tools you can lose in a 700 square foot space and how often you can lose those tools. You know, you just have no idea where everything went. But you lose them. You lose them, yes you do. Okay, so I'm going to start a little more at the edges here. Okay, curling over the edges, that looks good. Now I should be able to just kind of hammer on it and collapse it on down. Just a touch more heat. Read some comments. How are we all doing? None of them saw it. None of them saw it. That's fine. Okay. We don't have to comment about that, guys. Thank you very much for keeping that quiet. In-depth look at the forge. Understand this is one of Sam's prototypes. So this is just prototype. Super simple box, great little burner. Bricks on either end, close it up. Pretty exciting, eh, Sam? Somebody just asked, would I give the theory of quenching facing that magnetic any credence? Now, I'm no metallurgist, but I would say absolutely zero credence at all. I'm quite sure if the magnetic field in this earth were quite that strong. Well, I wouldn't be able to wear my belt buckle without being dragged north. That doesn't count. I caught it. Let's keep rolling this up. That's going well. I think this is going to be a cute little piece. I don't know why I'd use the word cute. That's a little weird. What did I say cool? This is a spear. This is going to be masculine. Picked the wrong word. It's like I said at the beginning, I forge very few sockets. You know, in fact, one I did on this show where I made an abomination of a scythe. That was actually very enjoyable to do, but again, abomination. Hopefully this goes a little better. Hopefully I've taken some of the things that I've learned from that, apply it to this, and it goes a little better. Have I ever used wet forging to reduce the scale on my works? No, I haven't actually. I'll try and do that on the blade when I get to it. That'll be fun. I'll grab some water and we'll throw it on the anvil, make some noise, it'll be good. But no, I'm... There we go. That's how I get the switch to happen. I know, I was just trying to talk to that one there. I was trying to talk to that one and I didn't realize it. Temperature. I don't know exactly what that is, maybe 1400 degrees Celsius. Something like that seems kind of pretty reasonable. I made that one piece a little while ago, that'd be perfect for this. Can't remember where I put it, however. Remember where I put that little bottom swage I made the other week? For that horse head. Nope, not that. I'm looking for like a 16 millimeter bottom swage. Sod floor. Wow,
right,
yeah. No, there's nothing over there anymore. Oh well. I'll have to make do without. We'll be aight.
Now, everybody wants to know exactly how tall you are. They want to see the measure you on camera.
I'm like 5'8", but I wear cowboy boots, so I'm like normal person, just. Definitely not the tallest person in the world. How tall are you, Sam?
5'11".
Wide.
Good old wide. Sam, would you care to entertain the audience? I need to go use the bathroom. Feel free to come stand up on stage.
Hi.
Yeah.
Can you turn your microphone on when you go to the bathroom?
I'm going
to
turn it off, yeah. If you go on stage with your mic.
My mic? Is that, wait, no, because it sounds like God.
I know,
my
exactly.
Mic sounds
if
like
you
God.
Run around on stage.
Mic working under pressure. What do you do? It only goes that far.
I don't think
you
can hear me anymore.
Is that... still sounding like
you
God?
Can still hear me. This is bad. You can still hear me.
Get free. Does that cut it?
Now I've just cut it. Great. Now you don't hear me piddle. Actually, can you pull that out of the fire,
yeah,
please?
I will pull that out of your fire. No one can hear what I'm saying. Hang on.
Health and safety.
Health and safety.
Can they hear me? Just about? I doubt it. I was just showing people how not to take up blacksmithing.
Drink. Sam, they want you to dance. And here we see Sam demonstrating how to brush. So exciting. We're temporary.
I don't really know where he's gone. I'll turn it on, don't worry. I don't really know where Alex's gone. I think he's either got lost, he's got stage fright, or he's got diarrhea. He hasn't eaten. So, yeah, this is a bit awkward really, isn't it? I better brush that again, it's getting hot again.
Now can you hear me? Coming through, Sam? What I said, I'll reiterate what I said. I came on, I said, when nature calls. Sorry about that, guys. And then I said, I felt much better, which I do. Appreciate your patience. This will do me any better. Take some smaller tongs. Did you enjoy your little cameo?
I did a bit of brushing with the glasses on.
Yeah, it's good. Right into the monitor. Okay, good.
I did a lot of dropping tools though.
You did?
For the drinking game.
Ah, oh, I see. Any better? I think so. Still don't quite have the grip that I'd like on this. And the tongs, not majorly thrilled about that. But socket is closing over nicely. Ah, I miss hit and I sent loads of scale up on myself. What you doing, Sam? What for? Oh, he's got a snow shovel. And this is gonna be a handle for it. Don't hit me with that.
A double-ended.
Double-ended. Multi-use. Multi-season. I'd need a different pair of tongs.
Michael Perkins requests a video about the different types of steel and the numbers used to designate them.
That's a great idea for a video. He wants a, Michael, thank you very much, wants a video for different steel types and what they're used for. That'd be a great thing for me to put out. It'd be really useful. It's something I always struggled with as I was getting into it. A ghost. All of this off, gently folding it over, and I dare say this is starting to turn out to be the best socket I've ever made. Not necessarily saying much, all the sockets up to date have been terrible, but I'm certainly quite pleased to be making a nicer socket than the original ones. I'm excited for how this piece is going to turn out, despite all these interludes. They're making French jokes in Twitch stream, which is nice. Half French, so it's all good, guys. No, it's good. Fire away. It's all good. No issues there.
Fire away. They'll only run away.
Sorry? What did you say?
I said fire away. They'll only run away.
Ah! I tell you what, it's bloody a bloody good job because you wouldn't be able to. Taken admirably, Sam. Taken admirably.
Like the British nails, please.
Don't sink it. Toxic in today's show. Okay. Gentle little blows. Excited about that. I'm really excited about how this is coming out. Oh. Oh, wonderful. Finally, a live show that's going successfully. Until it doesn't. Most of these live shows, if you're new, it's mostly me messing around, trying to get something done, and then nothing gets happened. So I got distracted while I was saying that, because I started looking at the monitor instead of the camera, and then I thought to myself, hang on, I like to look at the camera. Then I forgot what I was saying. Most live shows, in fact, all I do is I just try and make stuff new, and it doesn't work very well. And I have to guiltily say goodbye. Today, however, I think we're going to have a success, which is wonderful. many viewers do we have right now, Sam, on this today's somewhat sloppy stream? Apologies. Well, you know, still, are we going to complain about that? No. Not really. I'm still enormously grateful for you all hanging out here today. Thank you very much for being here. Take one more heat there on the socket, and then she'll be ready for finishing once it's cool. Excited. The spear isn't Damascus, no, on Twitch. Damascus Viking axe. I'd love to make a Damascus Viking axe at some point. But soon we're going to have no Damascus June. Shall I start that? Shall I make it a thing already? Yep, that's it. There is no Damascus June. I've announced it. In the month of June, zero Damascus will be made here at the workshop. My goodness, my most successful socket to date. Ha! I'm really thrilled about this. Alright. I'm gonna neaten up the transition and then flip her around. What fun! What fun! Mike DePell's parched. Fixed it. Alex Steele drinking game. If you're unfamiliar about the Alex Steele drinking game, what I would recommend for your libations for the evening is going to be some orange juice. People are feel free to be creative in the drinks that they choose to drink during the Alex Steele drinking game. Whole idea is I tend to drop a lot of things. I seem to be getting better at it lately, though, at not dropping things. The whole idea is I usually drop a lot of things and people like to... People like to cure their thirsts by playing the Alex Steele drinking game. Feel free to play along. Lovely. Exciting. Now I will turn it around. So there is the socket. If you go in close, Sam. Here is the socket. I'm actually really stunned with that. Next time I know I'm gonna have to focus on a different isolation technique so I can get even more material out wide to close it up at the base. I mean there's no worry on that, that's not gonna affect it negatively. Aside from that, it's nice and round. Nice and consistent. I'm just super excited. That's
they've changed the drinking game.
Yeah.
So every time you say how good the sock is, they're going to say.
I'm not going to forge weld the socket.
No, you're not going to forge weld the socket in my brand new forge.
You don't really get any flux in it? Sam's also soon going to be a welding flux supplier.
With Damascus billets.
With Damascus billets. Well, you still have to forge weld the Damascus together. But with steel for Damascus in billets, that's good. Exciting. What's the lead time on all that being set up?
Well, I'm going on holiday.
I don't have the choke open enough.
I'm going on holiday next week.
He's going on holiday next week.
So it'll be after that.
So it'll be after that.
But once the forges have got the price, there'll be a lead time for them anyway, but they'll right. Be up, the forges will be up.
Forges will be a pre-order. Nice.
Damascus coffee cup.
Damascus coffee cup.
Ivan Gustavo.
That's an interesting idea. It wouldn't work too well, though. The finish would be destroyed immediately. And I don't think you want to be oiling your coffee cups. How exciting. How exciting. On there from a miss hit I did a few heats ago. I'm actually gonna file that off real fast. Wants to see the straight razor, do they? AVE did email me, I believe. Sorry? Yeah, that'd be great. Making some fucking noises.
There's a growing equipment for a like a geologist hammer.
Geologist hammer. That would probably go viral. There are so many geologists in the world. But that's an interesting idea. I think a couple of people have asked that before. Thanks, Sam. That did terrify me. Until I saw it. Here's the straight razor. Really pleased with that. We go in for a number two. Here are the scales that nobody liked. I liked them a lot. There's the pattern. Really excited. Bronze pins riveted over. Took a long time to rivet this nicely. I took my time, it worked. Super pleased. I just need to get some more stones and a leather strop and be able to strop that perfectly and get it properly raising sharp, saving sharp. Or I just wait until a little more facial hair grows and then try shaving with it. Because I tell you what, it takes arm hair off like nothing at all. I'm now completely bald. Honestly, it'd probably be just fine. I don't know when you consider it sharp enough. I mean, it is popping it all off. Welcome to the Alex Steele Show, where Alex shaves his entire arm. That is just so satisfying. Okay, it's probably sharp enough. I'm just completely bald. It didn't pull at it either. So there we go. There is a straight razor. I'm excited about that. That was a fun piece. I'm gonna try and set that somewhere relatively safe. So much hate about the scales, which is fine. I'm just amazed that so many people cared enough to want to comment, though. Hasn't quite extended to death threats over the handle material choice. However, I think that's only a logical step from here.
Everybody loves the razor.
Sorry?
Everybody loves the razor.
Great! Well, the people on the live show, you guys all have great taste. Yeah, like, I mean, people were saying it's not enough, like exotic wood would have done it. I am amazed, actually. That shaved the hell out of my arm. There is nothing there. I'm bald again. Super smooth. A lot of people are like, oh, it's not enough. You needed some exotic. I don't want the handle to detract from the rest. I wanted it simple. Plus, I know that with the G10, it's a lot stronger than the wood. And so where it does have to bow in slightly, it's not gonna crack. And plus, it's my damn razor. I'll make whatever frickin' handle scales I want. And I think G10 is a rockin' material. It makes you think you have a tactical razor. Now, come on. If you're shaving, don't you feel better shaving knowing that you have a tactical razor? I certainly know I would. You know, empathizing for people that have to do it regularly. Because I don't. For a laser. Picatinny rails coming in next week for it. Bank holiday Monday messed up the shipment. But yeah, there's gonna be a Picatinny rail on it when it's finished. On the razor. Okay, so let's have a look at this. How are we looking? I need to try and pull this lobe here back out and down towards me. Aside from that, a little planishing and she'll be all good. I'm excited.
Would it have a solid if there were a pancake also?
Sorry?
Would it have a solid? Would it have a solid if there were a pancake master?
What?
A silencer and a pancake holster.
We'll have a silencer and a pancake holster. It is going to have a silencer, however, it's not going to have a pancake holster. It's actually, ladies and gentlemen, going to have a pancake cooker. Yes, that's right. Right now, for a limited time only, you can get your Picatinny rail equipped, laser sight clad, pancake cooking straight razor right now from alexsteelshop.com. Yeah, when I read that comment, I decided it was only going to be better if I actually thought of real pancakes. So recently, guys, I've been trying to eat a little healthier. I gave in to a slice of pizza that Sam and John Michael were eating. And I think that's kind of what messed me up and meant I had to take a little 5-minute break there earlier because I've been, you know, unaccustomed to unhealthy food. But I'm trying to eat healthy, and so whenever there's opportunity to think about sweet things, I just want to think about sweet things. So, like, all I want right now is to eat a big rack of pancakes. Oh my goodness, some pancakes would be so nice. Okay, do a little cleaning up with a rasp. How am I gonna hold that? Hold that right there. Farrier style cleaning. Forger thick and grinder thin. Yes, sir. Ain't that right, Sam? I'm denigrating farriers. It's all in jest. Not really. It is. There we go. There we go, a little cleaner in there. Now I'm gonna set her up here. little higher up so I can get a little more angle on it. And I think with one more heat, I should be finished. Sorry. It has to be this high. Otherwise I can't get the angle I need. Sorry for the noise. Has to be this high. Sorry for the noise. Sorry for the noise. Apologies again. Look at it from both sides. Make sure it's a little more even than it was. Great. Almost there, ladies and gentlemen. One more refining heat. Here is the spear so far. Whoa. Too little oxygen. There we go. How exciting. Oh, how are the YouTube comments coming along?
Just some hellos, Damascus frying pan.
Damascus frying pan, they said that on Twitter too. Yeah. On Twitch, pardon me. I got a box from the Samurai Carpenter. Golf ball on a file, yes. The reason for a golf ball on the file is so that when you're really bored, you can just play golf. Well, not really, you just play bouncy ball. Pretty fun, right, Sam?
Very much so.
Pretty good stuff. No, the reason for it, it's a really great rasp handle. I really like using those. A golf putter, that's an awesome idea. That's a really, really good idea. Thank you. Damascus steel golf putter. I believe Vegas Forge made a Damascus steel, golf putter, or at least they made the Damascus and then some golf company made a putter out of it. It'd be an exciting project to try and do it all. As I finish this up, I'm working my light hammer blows, round side of the hammer, working one side only with it. This way I get a cross section that's like flat, then radiused on opposing sides, which looks pretty cool. I saw Brent Bailey post a photo of something that looked a little akin to this. I believe inspired from a kind of an African spear. A little longer, different proportions. Similar kind of cross section, however. How exciting. How exciting. What fun this project has been. Okay. Next heat, I'm going to take a straightening heat, and I'm also going to put my touch mark on it.
They want to see the forge again this heat.
They want to see the forge.
Yeah, close-ups.
We'll get you some close-ups of the forge again. Sam's prototype forge, ain't that right? There she is. Make sure I got my touch mark. It only takes just a little bit of filing or grinding to get a nice edge on there. Like a secondary bevel, or you just hollow grind and flat grind it, following on what's already been done. What fun. Make sure that it's straight. So I'm gonna look down it, and what's the blow right here? Wow. Center line, it's good. It's pretty good here. Make that a little better. Yep, yep, yep. Brilliant. Okay, one little gentle heat. Consider it somewhat a vague little normalizing cycle. I'm gonna touch mark it here, brush it, and we'll be finishing off the show. So how many viewers do we have on YouTube currently, and how about on Twitch?
1500 on YouTube. I don't know how to tell them.
I'll go show you. So that thing is just gently radiating the heat up. Over here, here, 150. Look at all the amount of comments coming through.
I know.
Unbelievable. You guys rock. Have you read off all the super chats?
Really enjoy the camera work. Thank you for mentioning back boots. Waiting on my first pair.
That's great. Awesome. I hope you told them that I sent them. I sent you.
You do know that you'll have to upload a video where you throw the spear.
I know, apparently I have to upload a video where I throw this spear. Thank you very much. Appreciate the super chat and the great idea. It would be fun to throw the spear. I think I might have to. Okay, right here. Right there. Where am I gonna put this? Right like that. Had a decision made. Did you miss it, Sam?
No, I didn't. It's because you had it on the wrong screen. I was looking at the other screen. There was nothing.
Oh. Oh, well, there's the touch mark. That's so much fun. What a fun project. Well, I hope everybody has enjoyed this. It's been massive fun hanging out with you all. Appreciate all the donations through Super Chat and through Twitch. Very kind of you. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow on the next YouTube video. It's going to be a blast. It's going to be a blast. It's actually one that I recorded the other day, unboxing the Samurai box, and it's unfreaking believable. You're going to love it. You're going to really be excited for what's coming next regarding that box. So I'm thrilled for you guys to have that video. Tomorrow I'm going to be flying in a Second World War plane, not as a pilot, as a passenger, but that's going to be fun. Fun little day out. Might see it, get some footage from that. It might go on the YouTube channel, it might not, depending on how interesting it is. Aside from that, ladies and gentlemen, however, if we have a little nice little shot of this, I am just super, super thrilled to have had you here for this live show. It's been major amounts of fun. Please be sure to go and follow my other social medias. If you're not following on Instagram, please do. That's a great way to get some kind of behind the scenes of what goes on here and kind of updates and stuff like that, at Alex Steel Blacksmith. If you're on YouTube and you want to see some kind of behind the scenes as I make a lot of the projects that I make, go to twitch.tv/Alec Steel and get there. And of course, if you like the t-shirts and the merchandise that I wear and the hats that I wear in my videos and you want to support the YouTube channel and sport some pretty sick gear yourself, please go ahead and head over to alexsteelshop.com. Guys, it's been a major, major blast. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you, Sam, for the help. Thank you, John Michael, for the help. Thank you, guys, for watching this whole way through. It's been an absolute pleasure. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. If you haven't seen us, go make part 3 of The Straight Razor. Go check that out. And of course, have a fantastic day. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you very much.
No.